45 minutes. Hi guys, I am getting ready to go to the Fit Expo. I'm completely ready actually. I have everything all packed, I've got my backpack ready to go, I've got my suitcase ready to go. I spent a little bit of time this morning on IG Live, and before I went on IG Live, I journaled for about half an hour, maybe 20 minutes, half an hour. I just got this brand new journal. It's rose gold and marble, so I had to break it in for the new year. Journaling today was important for me because it's something that both my therapist has recommended and just like people around me have recommended in general, in order for me to get my thoughts out. As an external thinker, it's really important for me to consider both what I'm feeling and why I'm feeling those things. And something that my therapist suggested, when I know that I'm gonna be entering into really anxiety-inducing situations, that I prepare for those things, that I predict and prepare what sorts of triggers might arise. Me feeling overwhelmed, me feeling like I can't control my situation, me feeling like I can't control other people and other people's decisions. And so I predict and prepare for those things by journaling through them. So as I explained on IG Live this morning, what I do when I journal is actually a structured sort of journal, so that I'm not just meandering and complaining, because I don't want to spend time just complaining about what I'm feeling like. So the first thing that I do is accept the fact that I'm feeling particular feelings. And today when I was journaling, I accepted the fact that I felt a bit of worry, that I felt a bit of fear, and some anxiety about traveling, about all the things that I actually need to do this month of January. And by going away this weekend, I feel like I have to kind of put those things at least on hold for a little while, and that makes me feel a bit uncomfortable. And also, I'm going to be entering into an environment, this LA Fit Expo, where it's gonna be 80,000 people, and I'm gonna get to meet all kinds of people that I've been wanting to meet for a while, but in a way that kind of scares me a little bit. So just to be very honest with you, those are some of the doubts and some of the fears and worries that I was having this morning, and I knew that I needed to journal about it. After I accept those things, then I get them down on the page and I contextualize them. I think about why I'm feeling that way and I trace it through the whys. Well, I feel this way and I probably feel this way because of this situation, and I experienced a certain emotion during that situation because of this situation. And I sort of meander at that point, contextualizing my feelings. But I don't stop there. I always come forth towards some solutions. So I find some solutions at the end. And my four goals for myself this weekend, and hopefully throughout the course of this vlog, you guys will be able to see me actually accomplish some of these goals. I'm hoping. I have four different things that I want to kind of accomplish while I'm gone this weekend. My first goal is to be present, to not fixate so much on the things that are happening around me and every single person that I have to meet, but instead to really be present in my current moment. Number two is to be true and to represent myself truthfully, exactly who I really am, and also to represent Doughbar, these people that I love so much, really accurately. I want to be gracious and I want to be patient on a massive scale. There's gonna be so many people that I'm gonna have to talk with and work with and make donuts for. So I want to show thankfulness and graciousness in all of my interactions. Number three is to breathe, slow down, and privilege my mental health when I need it. One of my tendencies is to overcommit myself, spread myself too thin, and then I'm not really taking care of myself. I need to make sure that I am taking a break when I need to, that I'm eating when I need to, and that I'm not just spending my entire day at the booth working diligently, working hard, because again, that's a tendency. I have a responsibility and obligation, and I sometimes will spread myself way too thin and not ask for help. And number four is I want to have fun. I often ask myself when I'm training, when I'm putting my belt on, when I'm about to deadlift, you know, are you having fun right now? Because if I'm not having fun, why am I doing it? I don't want to complain. I don't want to be negative. I want to have a positive mentality, and I want to show my positivity in my actions throughout this entire weekend. So I hope that throughout the course of this vlog, I actually accomplish these goals. I have written them down for myself. I've actualized them. You know, I want to speak circles around myself and to speak those things into existence. I think that's really important, and that's one of the best parts about journaling for me, is being able to get those things out on the page and then see them, and then see those things manifest themselves.
Thank you.
for the other girls to get here, Ashley and Dallas. They're getting in at about 9:30, so I'm the first person to get here. And so I'm just gonna kind of chill for a little while and wait around. So I'm sitting upstairs waiting. I have still about an hour. Luckily I've got some protein bars with me, so I'm gonna eat those things, because as soon as I got off the plane, everything that was in the terminals, including like this big salad bar and this Greek place that I have eaten at before when I've flown into Long Beach, everything was closed. So I was like, well, I'm gonna be starving, because stupid me didn't eat before we took off. So I actually moved downstairs so that I could use the plug that's here so that I can go on live stream, because I might as well pass the time. We have arrived. This is Ashley. That is Dallas. That is Steve. How's it going, Steve?
Right.
We're taking an Uber to the Airbnb.
Which way you go? No matter which way you stay, you're out of my mind. Out of my mind. Out of my mind. Out of my mind.
Up on the little bright things I want, but I know they'll never own me.
City.
they do in the space. When my head's filling up fast with the wicked games up in flames, how can I fuck with the fun again when I'm known? And my bones turn up with their heads again, and then everything's cool when we're all alive for the throne. I'm showing people how little we care. We're so happy, even when we're smiling out of fear. Let's go down to the tennis court and talk it up like yeah. And talk it up like yeah. And talk it up like yeah. Let's go down to the tennis court and talk it up like yeah. And talk it up like yeah. And talk it up like yeah. Let's go down to the tennis court and talk it up like yeah.
Guys, good morning and welcome to day two. Today we are going right back to the expo. Crazy day. We were sold out, or not necessarily sold out, but we were completely out of our Doughbar samples by about 3:30 in the afternoon, even though the expo closes at 6. We probably gave out over 6,000 samples yesterday. It was a madhouse. It was so much fun. It was really, really cool to see so many of you. I got to spend time talking to people that I'd really wanted to meet for quite a long time, and then other people who I didn't know, or, you know, people who came up to me and they were like, hey, I followed you for a really long time, and I got to have great conversations with people. So I'm just so grateful to those of you. If any of you are watching and you came and said hi to me yesterday, I'm genuinely grateful. I left yesterday with my heart so full. I ended up being able to go and get dinner with a bunch of friends, and I was explaining to them before I left from dinner that I got a little emotional, and I was like, hey, like, I didn't really know what to anticipate coming in to the Fit Expo, because I knew that, you know, anxiety is something that I suffer with, and going into new situations, and so I was worried that maybe those expectations that I had, those really high expectations of really being excited and getting to meet people and spending time with them, that maybe those things wouldn't be met. But I was overwhelmed with gratitude for, especially, I just wanted to send a small shout out to Fit Girl Kelly, who's Kelly Lenahan, because she was so welcoming and gracious and inviting me to come to dinner last night, and that just made me feel like really fuzzy and warm on the inside. And I was telling them before I left yesterday that I was just so happy, and I was so grateful that I got to spend time with them. So in any case, today we're gonna go back to the Fit Expo and we're gonna start all over again. We'll probably be sold out of...
Do you think that we'll be sold out of samples, or that we'll be out of samples by the middle of the day again? Or do you think that we'll be able to last?
I don't know how much delays we made last time, but Marquez thinks we have a little bit more.
Okay.
So the thing, so
we're thinking that maybe we'll be able to last at least a little bit longer through the day. The lines were pretty crazy yesterday. We were like on a system, and then when we ran out of our little souffle cups, we had to find a new system, and that was really crazy. So it's just been like a fun experience so far. And then I fly out tonight. Kyle's been sending me videos of the fact that he completely changed our entire living room around. He switched everything. So those of you who are like familiar with the layout of our living room from watching all my videos, he's like, I redid the whole thing, and he sent me all these videos of it, and I'm like, what? Like, so we'll see what happens. I think that he was just like ready for a change, and when, you know, while the cat is away, the mice will play. So that's what he's doing. But I will see you guys at the expo. I'm so excited for day two, and I really hope that I get to meet so many more of you.
Day two. Oh, hi, boo.
Hey guys, welcome to the end of the video. So I kind of just stopped recording on Sunday because we just got so slammed by the end of the day trying to sell the rest of our boxes and just like the amount of people that I had met by that point. I just couldn't get everyone on film because I was just running around talking to everybody. So, and I think that's really just indicative of me actually being present and in the moment to the point where, you know, I had my phone with me and I took some pictures here and there, but the vast amount of people that I met versus the amount of people I actually was able to take pictures with is such a huge discrepancy because I just spend my time actually getting to know people and having conversations. And so I think that I did pretty well accomplishing the goals that I set out for myself going to this expo. Something that I didn't do well was actually taking care of myself that second day on Sunday, after the last clip that you saw with the enlightened ice cream and everything. I didn't eat that. That was for like an enlightened collaboration that we did on our IG stories. But I didn't eat like all day and I didn't drink any water and I ended up with a pounding migraine. And having to go to the airport that night with a migraine was not fun. So in the future, you know, and I had a conversation with Chris Lovato from, well, Legends of Aesthetics originally and obviously Gymshark now. But yucky, Chris was telling me, Ilyssa, you know, in the future when you go to expos, you need to make sure that you're like taking care of yourself, that you're drinking water. And he said that when he first started doing expos, he would just go all day and lose his voice on the very first day. And so I think that's something that I'm gonna have to take into account, especially if we're gonna do the Olympia in September, because that'll be even bigger than this. But I had such a great time reflecting back on it now, you know, a couple days later. I'm so glad that I went and I'm so glad that I got to have the time that I did with the people that I met. I really don't have complaints. I was so blessed and so privileged to be a part of the Doughbar team and to meet the people that I did and to meet all of you. Again, if you came up to me and you said hi and you took a picture with me or, you know, talk to me about your life, know that I'm grateful for that, that I'm thankful for getting to know you face to face. It really, really blessed my life. So I'm excited to do more expos in the future. I'm watching back this footage on this new lens. This lens is a 35mm 1.8 lens and I'm obsessed with it. It's absolutely beautiful. It functions more like a 50mm because the camera's not full frame. So I think probably the next thing that I'm gonna invest in is maybe a 24mm lens because that'll give a bit further away so that I can do a bit more blogging. Look how it like, it tracks too. Look at this. Okay guys, I'm gonna finish editing this vlog and pop it up there for you guys. I love you. Can't wait to see you in the next vlog. Bye.